watching this person, and if you can already tell, probably by the thumbnail and the title of this video, I'm a big Bob Ross fan. I mean, even take a look at my shirt. A lot of this is credited to my wife. I had no idea there was so much memorabilia. I'm not a big collector or anything like that, but I thought these were cool, like little knickknacks. I don't collect these Funko stuff, but she gave me this as a surprise last year, and it was so cool. I know I'm a nerd, I don't take it out of the box, but I mean, I'm not gonna play with it or anything, but I thought it was just cool. And stuff like that. So, I just wanted to show you guys some of the cool stuff and mildly throw in some ASMR, maybe some tapping. And I know the Bob Ross bobblehead. This thing is awesome. It actually plays, but it's gonna be a little too loud for this, and I know. Another video later on if interested with the other stuff, but I was planning on doing one with like paintbrushes and all that kind of jazz, but we'll see how this one goes. But let's start with this much, but here's a closer look at there's a couple of captions. Oh my god, I can't even hold these things right. Let's just say, let's get a little crazy in here. I loved one of his sayings was, we don't make mistakes, it's just happy accidents. It's just, you know, he just kind of goes with the flow. And this one says, I like mountains. And if you guys watch any of his shows, all of them are on YouTube now. So it's no excuse to miss them. But it was all pure nostalgia. And, you know, so. Back to kind of college days where, you know, late night studying and all that stuff. this outside though. Not that I'm proud of it. I'm not proud of it. It's just, I don't know. I'd rather. Makes me feel good at home. Alright, so next step. This thing just sits on my desk as a reminder. Responded to fan mail too. I mean, even back then. And if you notice, a lot of his paintings do have mountains in it. Obviously, yeah, he would say is he loves them big old mountains. Favorite places to be. Then he had to ultimately move to LA for his show. Thank you. just underneath my screen on my desk. And it's just nice to look at and, you know, take your eyes off of the computer screen. And I'm not doing myself any favors by starting this channel. Also, my grandmother got it at some Comic-Con, I think, or something like that, where you can only find it there. So obviously, super limited edition. But he was asking for, like, I think $5,000 for all three. And it turned out that his price was a little too high because he had some disappear.